There are a few different very nice programs that let you see a little bit more in depth into your vehicle's functioning, and you can get yourself set up on a fairly decent price. Now, the two I talk about, or I'm mentioning, are ScanMyTesla and TM Spy. Now, they're both available for iOS and Android. However, it's a little easier to get going on Android than it is with an Apple device. And I will touch on that in a moment. Well, let's touch on that now. For ScanMyTesla, now both let you see in-depth information on about your BMS. Let's see if I can get... Let's just go through pictures here. Battery information, you got DC to DC input power, just about all your energy specifications, voltages, currents, tells you like nominal full packs, charge cycles, temperatures, balance, torque, consumption, lots of good information. So this is ScanMyTesla. And then the other one, TM Spy, is a great one. That's a little tiny. Let me touch screen, zoom in. I use both in conjunction. Each one presents data a little differently and can, I don't know. TM Spy is a lot cleaner and a lot quicker to find what I'm looking for, whereas ScanMyTesla is a little more in-depth. And if you've watched my range update videos, you will see that I do touch on both. Now, App Store for Android, I kind of recommend picking up and just going with Android for both. Even if you're an iOS user, you don't need a cellular plan. You don't need anything special. I'm actually using a 10-year-old Android phone, Alcatel One Touch, I think, to monitor. It's just a little easier. You can pick up a used $10 or $15 or $20 Android phone with a nice big screen, and use that. And it's also a little easier to get the apps for Android, believe it or not. So ScanMyTesla, it's just under 10, it's around $10 on the Android or Google Play Store. And then same with TM Spy, that was about $10 as well. So you just go into the Google Play Store, search TM Spy. TM Spy is also available for the Nissan Leaf. And then ScanMyTesla, you just do a search and get those. Now for iOS, ScanMyTesla is a little newer to iOS. They had to rewrite the program from the ground up to work with Apple. And it's not quite up to par yet with the Android version, but it's slowly making it there, as you can see. I did not buy that yet. Now for TM Spy for Android... for TM Spy for Android, you can download, buy and download. For iOS, it is only available in test flight. So you need to request access in test flight to be able to get it. So I'm going to put a link to Tesla Motors Club so you can request test flight access to get it for iOS if you so desire. On top of having the app, you also need some hardware. So let's go on over to over here. Now this is the Bluetooth adapter I use for ScanMyTesla. I will have links to everything I'm showing you in the description box of this video. That price is jacked up once they realized Tesla owners were buying them en masse. And this works with Windows, PC, laptop, or Android. Not compatible with iOS. I haven't dug too much since I don't have the ScanMyTesla app for iOS. But I have not narrowed one down for iOS yet, but it works great for the Android version. So this is currently $89.95. If you can find a compatible one, awesome. For Scan My Tesla or TM Spy for both Nissan Leaf and Tesla, and for Android or iOS, so this works for all of it. This is the Li-Link OBD2 adapter, and it works fairly well. Price is reasonable. Not the fastest, but you don't even have to pair the adapter with your device. Whatever device you open up that has the program requesting data, it goes straight to that, obviously only one device at a time. So, I have, as you can see, I've purchased 6 times because I've broken a few. I still have 2 in active use today. I now leave them just plugged in full time. I've broken a few because I only had one adapter at a time, and I was switching them between 2 vehicles and now 3 vehicles. What else do you need? You need connection cables. There are a couple different cables depending on the model and year. So for Model S, there are 2 different cables. You have 2012 to 2015 because the port, see the white bit there? That is different. It's a 12-pin, I believe. Oh, OBDMX. Yes, there we go. That was the one. I knew I had one in my head for iOS. This one will work for Scan My Tesla for iOS or Android, but the price has jacked up. This was a ton cheaper. Same with this one. This is the one I have. It's cheaper, but I only use it with Android. I'm not planning on using the iOS version of Scan My Tesla just because the Android version is much better. So anyways, back to connection cables. There is a 2012 to 2015, September 2015 cable. I believe it is a 12-pin on the white connector there. And that goes over and converts it to an OBD2 connection. So you can use one of the adapters. And then here's the 20-pin. Works with October 2015 onward Model S's. And it has a 20-pin connector there on the in the white. Now, this will work with all of the Model X's. So you will need this one for the Model X, all of them. And between these two cables, okay, 2012 to 2015, and then this one will do Model S and X, 2015, September, all X's, and October 2015 onward, that used the 20-pin connector, until Tesla did the refresh design, or the got rid of the legacy design. If you have a legacy car, that would mean the S or the X with the vertical 17-inch screen. This is what you will then use. If you have the 17-inch horizontal screen, I am not aware of anything that currently works yet. I will report back, but I don't have a horizontal screen plaid or redesign car to test with yet. For Model 3 and Model Y, there are a number of different options. So I'm going to just link to this page. It uses a different style connectors, as you can see. Different years, 2019, 2020, 2021, 2022. This one's for 2019 to 21. 17 to 20, it's completely different. So I'm going to link to this. Here's got 17 to 18, 19 to 21. So it's all over the place. You're going to have to check your specific vehicle. I don't have a 3 or a Y, so I can't help you with that. But once you get the correct connector for your specific model and year, then you can just go and use Scan My Tesla or TM Spy to make the magic happen and connect up with your phone. I hope that was at least a little bit helpful here. I will have links in the description box below. I just get asked so much, especially on my range, 1,000-mile range update videos, how do you access this? And I mean, it's not as simple here, buy this, this, and this, without having to go through and break it down a bit. So there you have it. I will have links to everything, including I will have links to TM Spy and Scan My Tesla. TM Spy for iOS is just going to be the harder one, because you do need to request access from the developer for test flight for iOS. Again, your best bet for both of them, get yourself, if you don't have already, a cheap used POS Android phone that is compatible with the Bluetooth adapters, and just go from there. Doesn't need any special software updates, just good enough to download the apps. And that is it.